I feel like we had similar growths too. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
I heard you talking with Dylan about being fat. Well, I was also a fat kid, bro. Like,
they don't understand.
No, bro. People don't understand.
Okay, let's get it then. Yeah. This is important.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I heard both you guys talking about it, and I was like, bro, I need to be in on this too.
He doesn't get it. He's skinny.
He was skinny.
He got like buff.
Bro, is the like nah.
It's
like,
not the same.
It's not the same as like going from being a tubby kid that got bullied. You know what I'm saying? Like both every of us. Girl's best friend. I was a teddy bear.
Yeah, me too.
And then I hit like 14, 15 and I was trying to fuck. And like I'm too fat for that. You know what I'm saying?
When did you hit the growth spurt?
I did. So what happened is I actually lost the weight before the growth spurt. So really? I was playing football. I was like, bro, I looked like a meatball. I was like 5'4", like 200 pounds. Damn. Like I was just, bro, massive. And
fullback?
Fuck that, bro. I was D-lineman, dog. Like, I was the smallest D-lineman in history.
They just needed the weight.
They needed the size. They did. And then, so I was like 5'4", like close to 200 pounds. And then that was freshman year. Summer between freshman and sophomore year, bro, I dropped like, fuck, it was like 80 pounds. Like I got down to like 120. I mean, I was 5'4", so like wearing 120 at 5'4" wasn't that big of a deal. I wasn't underweight, but I cut like a crazy amount of body fat.
Yeah.
And then I grew from there and then started to slowly put muscle back on. But like it was drastic, like super, super drastic.
How'd you lose so much weight so like in that time? Was it just puberty?
It was puberty. It was also like a combination of I started high school football, like taken super seriously.
Yeah.
And I tried to just eat better. Mm. Or I guess like eating better but eating less. Like looking back on it, it probably wasn't like a great way to go about it, but I was young and I was doing so much activity that it wasn't hard once I just started making conscious choices. You know what I'm saying? Like it really wasn't like the hardest thing in the world.
Yeah.
But you know, I've always been dealing with the yo, I don't want to get fat again. So like I'm trying to just watch my weight work out and you know. But yeah.
So you were conscious enough at the age to be like trying to fix it that early on?
Basically? I think I wasn't until something clicked in me and I was like, dude, I don't want to grow up and be a heavy set man. Whoa. You know, like it's okay to be a chubby kid. It's a lot tougher when you're a big man. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know obviously like no disrespect to big dudes. Like, I mean, I have a lot of friends who are big, who pull and have great lives, but like it just wasn't what I wanted. Like I come from a heavy set family and I was like, you know, I need to make a change because heart disease, blah, 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 all this stuff. You know what I'm saying? So
do you have that in your family?
I do.
It runs like in your family?
I do.
Yeah.
I feel that. And diabetes. So it's like
same.
I had to come.
I didn't hear that thought. I mean, I didn't like think about that early on like that.
Yeah.
I was just more like, you know what's crazy, bro? This is kind of funny. Is I had a stomach bug when I was like 14. I just got sick like one weekend. This is literally how I remember it. I was fat and then I got sick and vomited for like 3 days. And then I was like skinny and tall.
So that was the change.
Like way less intricate. That's
crazy.
Yeah, for me, like I didn't, because I grew up, like my biggest vice was just like eating, like overeating basically. But it's because my family, like, oh bro, couldn't escape it. Like,
I feel you.
They didn't know anything about like nutrition or just
100%
ate whatever they cooked and it was mostly carbs.
You get pressured by your family. Like I'm not eating enough. Like still. Yeah, bro, same shit.
And I mean, I know that's like that's what they know. You know, obviously they don't have that awareness of like, you know,
it's love.
It is. Yeah, it's a form of like love. Even now, like when I notice that I'm stressed out and stuff, I'll find myself like I want to dip back into these tendencies. Like when I eat a good meal, it makes me just feel like. Like loved. It's weird.
No, seriously.
You know what I mean? But I go back to those days where I was like fat and sad and eating like this terrible meal. Well, amazing. Tastes great.
Yeah.
But horrible for me. But yeah, I remember like being so fat, bro, and then just like not being fat.
That's like, crazy. Like being,
but
that's
then night and day. My life changed for me though, you know?
You just, what, after that happened, you were like, I'm just trying to keep it off as much as possible?
That, not even that. It was more like how do I explain this? I just felt the change of how everybody started to treat me. That's really what it was.
Interesting.
And then after that, like my own self-worth started to like change a little bit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because before it was the same way. It was like very passive, little chubby fat kid. All the girls were like, oh, you're so cute. Little, you know what I mean? And then I got like handsome and beautiful.
Handsome. Tell the kids.
Handsome and wealthy.
That's how it goes. That's all it is. You got to get one stomach bug and you're handsome.
That's it.